Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from a Leopardstown racecourse here on Thursday. It's the 26th of December, 2019. I'm going to look at the stakes races on the program from Leopardstown, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for racecourses around the world. Let's get to the stakes action from Leopardstown races 3 and 5, the 110 and the feature 220. The third race, the 110, it's the Grade 2 Knight Frank Juvenile Hurdle. Grade 2 event going for a purse, $57,500, race for 3-year-olds only. We have 8 horses going 3,200 meters or 2 miles over the hurdle course. My top selection, I'm going to go with the one horse, A Wave of the Sea. We'll go 1-5-3 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 1-5-3 Tri-Cash Trifecta. Top selection, one horse, A Wave of the Sea. 3-year-old gelding by Born to Sea. J.J. Slevin is on this one for Joseph O'Brien. The horse's most recent outing came in the Grade 3 30 free bet VarinRacing.com Juvenile Hurdle at Ferry House, 2 miles over the hurdle course, December the 1st. He finished second by 2.25 lengths there. The winner, Sarah Barris, just took off clear that day. This horse, he was under the drive. It was excelling a little bit, but I just think they were asking a little bit too much too soon. This race isn't the world's toughest Grade 2 in the world. Actually, I think last time I owned the Grade 3 at Ferry House, that was a lot tougher than this group today. I think coming here to Leopardstown, which is a little bit easier place, I think, to jump around, I think we'll get a better trip, and I think I'll run a good race. Before then, a juvenile hurdle at Down Royal, the 2nd of November, 2 miles and a 16th, he won by 20 lengths there, and he just won nicely, easily. What more can I say? It was just a very easy run, and then his second over the jumps came up Hunchestown, the 15th of October, 2 miles in a juvenile hurdle. He won by neck that day at 80 cents to the dollar. It was a tough group of horses. He had a few subpar jumps, but he got the job done late. It was a good run there with a very low weight of 148 pounds. And then a juvenile hurdle before that, Lismore, 8th September, the 2-mile trip. First over the obstacles, he finished second by half length. And again, he closed up well. He jumped well. It wasn't a bad race at all. And, you know, before that, he was running over the flat and wasn't really showing up. But I like him here over the jumps. Like I said, last time out, that was actually a very tough race. Coming here, step down class. I'm going to take him at 7-2. So to recap my selection for the 110, the third race from Leopardstown's Grade 2 Knight Frank Juvenile Hurdle. Let's take the one horse, a Wave of the Sea. We'll go 1-5-3 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. Let's get to the fifth race, the feature 220 from Leopardstown, which is the Grade 1 Racing Post Novice Chase. It's a Grade 1 event going for a purse of $115,500, race for 4-year-olds and upwards. We have 5 horses going 3,400 meters or 2 miles and 1/8 over the chase course. I'm going to take a shot with the 2-horse notebook. We'll go 2-5-4 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 2-5-4 Tri-Cash Trifecta. Top selection to 2-horse notebooks. 6-year-old gelding by Sam Rum here. Rachel Blackmore's on this one for Henry Day Burhamhead. The horse's most recent outing came the 16th of November at Punchestown, 2 miles in the Grade 2 Craddockstown Novice Chase. He won by 5 lengths that day, and you know, it was an all-around great run. He ran in well. It was a very good run, second over the bigger obstacles. First over the bigger obstacles came at Punchestown again, 2 miles the beginner's chase, 15th of October, and he won by 2.75 lengths. Was the favorite that day, you know, just over evens, and he just took off clear, supposed to win, and he won quite nicely. And then before that novice hurdle at Punchestown during their May Festival, 2 miles, he finished second by 6.25 lengths. Now 20-1 outran the odds, had a high weight, but you know, still jumped a terrific race there. And then before that, they ran the horse in the Ballymore novice hurdle at Cheltenham in March. He finished 12th by 50 lengths, and we're still waiting for the horse to finish the race. That's how horrible he ran. He didn't jump well. He just wasn't handling Cheltenham that afternoon. But before that, Thurles on the 21st of September, 2.5 miles in the Grade 3 Bat Victor Michael Purcell Memorial Novice Hurdle. He finished second by 2.75 lengths, and again, he was closing up well. If the race, say, was the extended 2.5 miles, probably would have won, but I like him a lot. He's coming to this race well. He's coming to Leopardstown for the bigger obstacles. 6-1, let's take a shot. Like I said, I just don't trust those lower-priced horses in this one. So to recount my selection for the 220, the fifth race from Leopardstown, it's Grade 1 Racing Post Novice Chase. Let's take the 2-horse notebook. We'll go 2-5-4 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. So good luck to all. Please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5. Good luck, everybody.